times you dehydrate. Good God. See, we can go for days on there, Pastor Richard, Pastor E. We can go for days. Good God, the Holy Ghost and I know how to squeeze the juice out of the thing. Amen?
Amen.
Woo. God said, I don't need much to show you. I'm going to push you to the next level. And so many of us, I'm getting ready to sit down in a few minutes. Many of us, so we're going to say, don't dehydrate. Because many of us are dehydrated. Not because we don't go to church, not because we don't go to Bible study, but because God is calling us to a next level and we won't go.
That's right.
And so we on that same level trying to do the same thing. You know what? It's insane when you try to do the same thing, trying to get somewhere different. That's called insanity. And so many of us walking around in insanity. So, okay. Lord, why have you forsaken me? No, no, no. I ain't forsaking you. I need you to go to the next level. I need you to treat folk a little different than you've been treating. I need to shut your mouth. I need you to shut your mouth a little more than you've been shutting it. I need you to catch your tongue a little more than you used to. Oh my God. I need you to love your neighbor a little more than you've been loving. I need you to give a little more than you've been giving. I know you're about to choke me now, Jesus. I need you to let go of your own will. I can't do what I want to do, God. I can't go where I want to go. Not if you want to go to the next level. Amen. Jesus is trying to get to the next level. What he was trying to do, he was, first of all, God used him for us, for our sins to be ratified, for us to be able to walk in righteousness. But then when he rose up, he had all power. He was in another level. Amen. He ascended. Oh, God. Did he not? Was he not on another level?
Amen.
Amen. He came down from glory to show us how to go up. Oh, my God. Ooh. Ooh. So anytime you feel like you're dehydrated, anytime you feel like you're thirsty, you know you love the Lord. You say, Lord, what the devil are you trying to get me to now? Am I going to the next level? Do you want me? Huh, sometimes God will have you skip some levels.
Mm-hmm.
How faithful are you on the level you reside on?
Amen.
Amen. How quickly you respond to your thirst. Because some of us, you know how we say, I do not like water, y'all. I don't like water. Some folks drink 60. You know, we're supposed to drink 64 ounces a day. I'll be struggling to get 3 cups. Amen. But when I realize it's what I need, and I realize if I don't drink water, I will dehydrate. It don't matter how much you like the word or not.
Amen.
I'm going to drink it. Because I know if I don't, I'll dehydrate. But let me tell you what God did for me. I'm getting ready to close here right now. Let me tell you what God did. I've been drinking a lot of water lately. Don't y'all know God will meet you halfway? So you know what I've been doing? I've been putting them little high seat packets in my water. I've been like, go, go, drink some water. God, boy, put a little flavor in the word for you. So you won't drink it plain. Let me put a little flavor in it. It's the same. now how God loves us. Won't he meet you? He'll meet you. He brought his son down here to meet us. We'll put a little flavor in it. For 3 years, he walked the dusty roads and gave them old Pharisees and them Sadducees some flavor. Ooh. Ooh, just so we could receive it. He died on the cross, rose on the third day. You talking about some flavor? Who done that? Anybody? Who's ever done that? Anybody done that? Just so he can save us. Want to put some flavor in. Thank God for flavor. The first flavor flavor. I'm done. Y'all give God a hand clap of praise. Love on him. Love on him. Ah, to God be the glory. We're done. Happy Easter, everybody. Ooh, anytime anybody try to make your God seem unassigned, come on, he's the first flavor flavor. Put some flavor in it. For you. You get plain like you want. That's all right. But I'm going to get some flavor in my water. Because guess what? He put some flavor. I'm going to drink a whole lot more.
Amen.
Ooh, Jesus. Happy Easter, everybody. You look good. And we're done. I had some notes, but I had scripture and everything. But the Holy Ghost said, this is what I want to say. I got to say about that, because that flavor water kind of good, girl. It put a whole new spin on that. I'm sitting there drinking. I done drank about, you know, them little water, new water bottles of 16 ounces. I done drank about 3-4 of them daily. Man, look what a little pack of new. Look, we had to brought some more water. We running out. Kids drinking water. They don't drink it because they like them little flavor packs. Ain't it good when you run out so God can fill you with some more? Or we can go all day, y'all. I thirst. Don't dehydrate. God will give you some flavor. Amen. Go run, tell that. Go post that. Amen. Look at the baby. Oh my gosh, she got the roses on. Amen. Anybody who stand to your feet? We're done. We love you. We want you to enjoy your Easter with family, friends. Again, we want to thank God for the words that had gone forth. Thank God for Elder Sharon and the word that went forth for the children. Amen. Again, we thank God for Pastor Richard for representing on this week. I kept hitting Pastor. I said, Pastor, y'all to be proud. Amen. So again, we were thankful for the words that went forth. I thirst. Don't dehydrate. Get some, let God put some flavor in it. Amen. Flavor! What's the flavor of the week? Jesus. Always Jesus.
Amen. God is good. Which I knew God had to throw stuff together, amen, put it just right. And it's amazing how today, amen, it just flowed. Amen. From the beginning to the end, from the rooter to the tutor. Amen. Like you said, a brand new flavor year.
Oh, amen. My God. Now
he to you. Amen. Just so you can hear it, amen. Whatever makes you tap, amen. Whatever makes you stomp your feet, amen. Tap your fingers. God will put a brand new flavor in your ear.
Woo!
Lord have mercy.
I knew Pastor, he gonna mess around. Grind that thing in.
Oh, Jesus. I tell you, that's what I love about my God, but he gonna put it all together.
Amen.
Going from being thirsty. And only one thing can quench it, that's that living water.
Yeah.
Amen. Yeah. And then realize you don't want to dehydrate.
Yeah. Come on.
Woo, Lord have mercy. Yeah. Well, I tell you, I love it when the plan comes together.
Oh, okay.
Yes, Lord.
The Holy Ghost, and we being on one accord. That's what one accord look like, y'all. That's what the upper room look like.
Yeah.
Woo, quick God.
Amen. You can ask for anything better. Amen. A great word and message on today. Just name and understand, amen. It's good to thirst.
Amen.
Amen. It's good to thirst.
Amen.
Amen. But it's also better to know what will quench you.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. Ain't nothing wrong with thirsting, amen. But you got to get the right stuff in you to quench you.
That's right.
Amen. That's why the Gatorade and all that stuff, which, of course, it was for the sports athletes. They got all that other stuff in there, but it won't last long. It gives you that quick burst. Mm-hmm. Amen. That's how we do in life sometimes. We just got to get a quick fix. Mm-hmm. Amen. But I'm glad we got a Savior that's a long-lasting fix.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
He said that water that you'll never thirst again. Amen.
Never in this supply.
Won't dehydrate.
Never run out.
Lord have mercy.
Thank you, God.
We thank God for that word on today. Amen.
Lord, thank you.
We need to sit and contemplate.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Whatever it is that you've been going through, God was just trying to get you to the living waters.
Yes.
Amen. He was trying to let you dehydrate, but he wanted to move you to that next place.
Yes, thank
you. Amen. That next level of operation.
Yes, God.
Amen. And in order to get there, that's just like anything else. When you finish running the race or you about midway, just like you run the marathon, they got people along the way getting water drops. Because you get thirsty in your marathon run.
Yeah.
Amen. They know you need to rehydrate yourself. So along the way, there's always some folks, amen, and volunteer, here goes some water. Mm-hmm. Amen. And you keep moving. You don't stop the drinking.
That's
amen.
Right.
That's the thing about a marathon race. You don't stop the drinking. Every now and then you might spill a little bit.
Go ahead,
they
Pastor.
They get that cup. They drink it. Throw the cup, man, and keep rolling.
Go ahead, Pastor.
Amen. And your journey of life, amen, you can't stop. Amen. Just drink the water and keep rolling.
Woo.
Amen. Because you want to make it to the finish line.
Oh, yeah.
Because it said he doesn't endure to the end.
Yes.
Amen. So we want God to get you to that finish line hydrated.
Yes. Thank you. Woo.
So you get to the finish line, you can shout.
Hallelujah.
If he ain't got enough left, amen, you can't even go shout when you get to the finish line.
Hallelujah.
Amen. You just plop down. But God wants you to get to the finish line and got a praise in your mouth. Amen.
Yes.
A dance on your step.
Hallelujah.
Oh, glory.
Thank you.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Woo. You just need to sit and think about that thing.
Taste right. Good. Woo. Woo.
Mm.
Taste and see that the flavor is good.
Mm. Give you what you need.
I can't.
Ooh, Lord.
Ain't nobody love you like the Lord.
Mm.
Woo! Woo! Thank you for that water. Thank you!
Awesome, awesome, mighty God.
Woo.
Thank you. Come with all different flavors. Because some folks don't like orange.
Some folks don't like
grape. Amen. Some folks don't like peach tea.
Some folks love that tropical, don't they?
But I guarantee you, he got something just for you.
Woo!
Amen. That'll get your taste buds. What's your brand new flavor?
Woo!
Woo! Lord have mercy.
Tropical blacks.
Well, I tell you, we're going all day.
Woo!
Lord Jesus.
Woo! Holy Ghost, man, leave me alone.
That's the God we serve. Mm-mm-mm. Just excited. To know when you come in there and all them times you was thirsty, God was just moving you and taking you somewhere.
Yes.
Amen. You thought you was getting tired, but God just wanted you to take a drink.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Mm.
Amen.
Take a drink. I know it's strenuous. I know it's been pulling you down. I know it's been weighing on you. He just said, take a drink.
Take a drink.
Take a drink.
Thank you, Lord.
Let me replenish you. Amen. Let me put some water back in your cells. Ooh, Lord have mercy.
Ooh, thank you, Lord.
Mm-mm.
Thank you, Jesus.
All the way from science to supernatural. It's all right to take a drink.
All right.
Amen.
Yes.
Ooh, Jesus. Brand new flip.
Yes.
Give it to you just like you want.
Woo. Yes, God. Cup, glass, squeezy bottle. Wine glass. What time you want it?
How do you want it?
Don't worry about the container, because the message ain't
going to change. You want it. Amen.
Woo!
However do you want it.
Tell me how you want it.
Yeah.
Can I give it to you just like that?
Thank you.
Woo! That's why I love him so much. That's why I love him so much.
Thank you, Jesus. I don't know about you, but that's why you can just feel good and excited.
Taylor made just for you and me.
Because of that personal relationship. God said, I got you covered. Because I know you don't drink anything. I don't care how good it is for you. But I give it to you, amen, because I want you to be healthy. Yeah. I want you to be whole.
Yeah.
I said, you won't take it like that, amen. I meant it just so you'll love it. Woo. But you still get the same thing. Amen. It's still going down the same way.
That's why I'm getting mad. It's so many churches because everybody want a different flavor.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Lord have mercy. But when you come to that understanding, you realize that you don't have the only flavor. Mm-mm-mm. Because Jesus is the way, the only way.
Amen.
And as long as that component is there, amen. H2O is H2O.
H2O.
I don't care how you flavor.
Yes.
Amen. Two hydrogen, one oxygen.
It's still amen. Water.
It's still water.
Thank
amen.
You.
It's still what you need. Thank you, Jesus.
Hard ice, liquid water, or vapor.
Mm-mm-mm. Amen. We just thank God. Amen. We desire to pray, amen, on today, on this Resurrection Sunday. We just want to pray, amen, because God has replenished us.
Yes.
Amen. Some ever good tasting water.
Yes.
Amen. Something that you don't mind drinking. Amen. It goes down smooth.
Yes.
Amen. And we just thank God for it, amen, because He just loves us just that much.
Yes.
Amen. Our trials, amen, was to get us thirsty.
Yes.
Tribulations to get us thirsty.
Yes.
Amen. The situations, amen, were to get us thirsty.
Yes.
Amen. The hardships was to get us thirsty.
Yes.
Amen. So we realize that we need to drink a little bit more.
Yes.
Amen. We've been sipping on this too long.
Woo! Go ahead.
Amen. God says it's time to take some big gulps.
Woo! Get strong. Woo!
It's time to take some big gulps. Amen. You've been sipping too long. Because sipping, amen, ain't going to sustain you. It's going to tease you. Because your body's going to want more. Your body's going to want more. God said, time off for sipping. Mm. I always like a big gulp anyway. I go just like it at 52 ounces. Amen. I ain't never going to sip. Thank you, Jesus. Your trials will keep you thirsty. Y'all thirsty. You've been through some things, amen. God saying you're thirsty.
Yeah.
Amen. I'm just trying to get you to take the gulp. Take the gulp.
Hallelujah.
You've been keeping me around, sipping on me. Amen. But you know what? That's why it's living waters, because He'll replenish you.
Yes, He will.
You can't drink it all. Amen. Because every time you need some, God said, I got the water for you.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. That's your name.
Thank you, God.
Whatever it is, amen, that you've been going through, your issues, your concerns, God said today, amen, the living waters is being poured on you. Amen. Replenish your inside and your outside. Amen. Think about them good living waters and hot springs. Amen. They said they do a lot for you. Amen. They just make your body just feel so good. Amen. Just to take a dip in it. So not only can you drink it, but you can just lay in it.
Amen.
Amen. It'll get you all the way around. On the inside and I'll make your skin clean. Amen. Fresh.
Amen.
God saying, I'm on your skin. Amen. By the inside is renewed, amen. Now I'm about to do some work on the outside.
Yes.
You about to feel and look good.
Hallelujah.
Ooh, Lord have
thank
mercy.
Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
Living waters.
Hallelujah.
Regenerate.
Yes.
Replenish.
Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Let God renew.
Thank you, Jesus. But the enemy thought he was slowing you down and taking you out. And I said, I'm just letting my baby be thirsty. I want to see him drink. He just wanted to see you drink.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Everybody, walk toward you. We're going to pray. Amen. Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you right now for your child, God. Lord, we ask right now that you continue to rest, rule, and abide with her, God. But Lord, as she seeks you, God, continue to give her the living water that she needs for the next life. thank you that you let her know that this same level is not enough. Hallelujah, she thirsts. But God, we ask right now by your strength and by your power that when she leaves here on today, that you usher her into that living water, that next level, God, for your glory. And that she'll find, God, that as she's ushered into the living water, that all the issues and all the problems will wash away. Wash away. God said, wash away. The only thing that's going to fix it is the living water. It's going to wash it away. Hallelujah. Many times we're trying to fix stuff ourselves. God said the only thing that's going to fix this and wash it away is the living water. But the only way you're going to lay hold is you recognize that you're thirsty and you go to the next level in Him. And Lord, we ask right now that you usher her by your glory, by your power. Lord, we ask that you close all doors that would hinder her from going straight forward. Devil, doors that you open shall be closed. Right now, in the name of Jesus Christ. And that one door, good God, there's a door, there's a door, there's a door. That one door opens. Ooh, good God. Only after God closes the devil doors will the door he has for you open. The son of the Lord, she cannot. Hallelujah. Close all the devil doors, God, and open up your door. Living water will wash away all that other stuff. Ooh, let me give you a timeline. Let me give you a timeline. See, he gonna wash away, good God. Then he gonna close them doors. Then his door is gonna open. In that order. Ooh, good God. Living water first. Ooh, hallelujah. You ain't the only one that need that. Somebody need that, so you need to run tell somebody else that. Living water first. Then the devil gets shut down. Then his door will open. God's door will open. In that order. In that order. In that order. In that order. In that Señor Ocho. In that order. In that order. Ooh, good God. In that order. Ooh. Ooh, wash away. Devil's door closed. God's door open. Ooh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you, God. Rebuild. We still rebuild. Sometimes you do know this is nothing in regard. He got to shut doors in order to open his. We already just talked about it. And so you got to understand that there's some situations where you feel like you're alone now. So you are thirsty.
Yes, yes, yes.
So you can get that living water. I'm alone now. I'm alone. You are not alone. Jesus. You are not alone. The devil is a lie. And Christ said, don't you think more of me than to know that you are not alone. I'm offended that you think you're alone. Long as you've been in the church, long as you be telling folk about Jesus, and yet and still, when you go home, your thought is, I'm alone. You are not alone. Ooh, good God. You've always had me, but now I've made your path clear. You are not alone. God said, I love you. I always loved you. Always kept you. And yet you say you are alone. The devil is a lie. Remember that. You are not alone. Talk to me. I understand that you talk to other folk about me, but you talk to me. You talk. I want to hear your voice calling out my name and having a conversation. Have a conversation with me, God said. I want to talk to you. I want to teach you. I want to give you revelation. Talk to me. God crying out to Kim. Come on, Kim. Please talk to me. what God said. Take this home with you. Them same conversations you were having with your mama, have it with me. It's just that simple. Them same conversations you were having with your mom, have it with me. Just like you could talk to your mama, you can talk to God. And guess what? He will respond. Can you do that, baby girl? You are not alone. You were never alone. Amen. Somebody give God a hand clap of praise. Love on him. Love on him. Love on him. Love on him. To God be the glory. God loves you. He just won't talk to us. Hallelujah. Amen.